those waves.
I'm Ryan, scuba instructor and shark enthusiast. I've spent the past 4 years preparing to live on the ocean with my girlfriend and my dog. I am excited to sail to dive destinations and meet new creatures.
I'm Emily, a former data analyst who is ready to get out of the cubicle and onto an adventure. And this is Doug, our four-legged fur child who goes with us everywhere. One day we can get away, leave it all behind. Oh, we gonna run wild. Together we bought and refurbished Aquila, a 1979 Pearson 365 ketch. Oh, we gonna run wild.
Join us for our first season as we sail south from Central Florida. We swam in the
night. When we got Aquila, we started what would become a very long list of projects. Last week, in our very first episode, we took you through a few of our first projects, including our dry dock period. Since we were crunched for time, trying to get her ready to live on, we decided not to film boat projects for the most part. So to give you an idea of all the things we did and still have to do, here's a look at our project list, or what we can remember of it now. By the time we got Aquila back to Clearwater from the yards in Tarpon Springs, we had knocked out most of the projects on our list. But we were only 6 days away from moving on board.
Woohoo! Those waves.
Bottom of the wood. See that line? Yes. Follow that all the way back to the cockpit and then loosen it. Yeah, you see how it's spinning up there? And now that line is spun around the sail. I'm gonna go back up now. Oh, it's just this bird ball stuck in there. I got the light bulb out, unpip me. Oh boy, oh, watch out sail. The upholstery on Aquila was original and it all needed to be replaced. This was a project I had hoped to finish before we moved out of our house, but the marina dock turned out to be a pretty solid workplace.
Very first step in upgrading to lithium batteries is removing the old batteries. Our batteries were in the form of
75 amp hour, 6 volt golf cart batteries. 4 of them for a house bank. No one lived on this boat. We are changing that. All right, I got this one disconnected. Sorry, inverter. I mean, it's not too bad like up in here when they did the 120, it's all nice and pretty, but then the previous owner is just like wired stuff without putting the wires where they belong. If they're just hanging.
Can you give me the dikes?
I don't know what those are. I always forget.
Extra battery cables, just chilling. Like, this isn't even connected to anything.
I need wires, man, I swear.
Stupid, this is gonna take me hours.
Can I get down in there and help you or something?
You might have to go down here.
I mean, it just might be easier.
You can get all the big cables out.
So unscrew, cut everything that big cables are connected to.
Okay.
We're young.
I'm going in the locker. Cut out all these cables. The tight squeeze.
Turns out working down in the lazarettes is one of my favorite things to do on the boat.
I couldn't figure out how to get those wires out while it was at that weird angle, so I just cut them. This is so much lighter than our energy. If this was a burrito, I could eat it.
More gently than last. I moved it. Yeah.
Just push it all the way. There you go. Nope.
Nope what?
Nope, we gotta pull the battery out.
Why?
You don't see the problem here?
You need to turn it around?
Yeah.
Okay. You don't have to pull it all the way out, just turn it around.
Batteries are in.
Of course, how would it be easy? Nothing's easy.
This used to be where our propane went originally on the boat. There's this box in here and it had a vent to allow the heavy propane gas to escape in the event of a leak. But because that was an intrusion point for water, we sealed it up with 5200 and starboard. Mm-hmm. And then I flex sealed all around it. It's now not exposed to the outside. So there's no holes for the wires to go through for our inverter. So I'm gonna drill some holes for wires. Do you wanna drill one? No. Dude, that's some really strong wood. A violent blade. I'm gonna give you two.
Alright. Both tight.
They don't have to be super tight. That is, what did I say that was? That's our 120.
And then you said blue shorty, no.
Okay.
We are putting on our new anchor chain today.
I just vacuumed out the anchor locker. We just pulled everything out of it. There was only about 30 feet of chain and a bunch of line.
200 feet of anchor chain, and it is G43 or G4 high test galvanized steel. We are installing zip ties every 25 feet. So as the colors pop out, we can see how much scope we're putting out.
Hey not to pump it up, wait till high tide and kick it over into the water. I got my dinghy out.
There you go. He just needs to sit right there. Now that we had our new dinghy, it was time to go for a sunset dinghy cruise.
It's all fun and games until you run aground trying to get a shot of the moon.
I'll get out, Ryan, if you want. No, my shorts are shorter than yours.
Okay. Dude, that moon looks wild.
I know, I was trying to film it. We just wanted to say thank you so much for watching episode number 2.
If you enjoyed it, please subscribe, hit the like button, leave us some comments, let us know what you think. If you want to buy us a beer, you can go over to our website at runwildsailing.com.
Stay tuned. We are coming out with an installation video with our 600 amp hour lithium battery bank. And we are also going to release a video soon about installing our Sun Pure 30 gallon per hour water maker.